So, welcome to our Easter cantata. The title is Crown Him. We're here to celebrate the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Who came to this earth to pay the price for our sins. He paid the price on Calvary's cross, and he didn't stay dead, did he?
No.
He rose. Our King lives forever. Amen.
Amen.
So, join us as we celebrate our Lord and our King, Amen. Jesus Christ.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the Son of David. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the King. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Jesus who had blessed them, close folded to his breast. The children sang their praises, the simplest and the best. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the Son of David. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the King. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest, that ancient song we sing. Christ is our Redeemer, the Lord of heaven, our King. Oh, may we ever praise him with heart and life and voice, and in his blissful presence eternally rejoice. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the Son of David. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna to the King, the King. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Lord Hosanna.
Who has believed our report, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he shall grow up before him as a tender plant, and as a root out of dry ground. He has no former comeliness, and when we see him, there is no beauty that we should desire him. He is despised and rejected by men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief, and we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we did not esteem him. Surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows, yet we esteemed him stricken, smitten by God and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned every one to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He was led as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before its shearers is silent, so he opened not his mouth. He was taken from prison and from judgment, and who will declare his generation? For he was cut off from the land of the living. For the transgressions of my people he was stricken, and they made his grave with the wicked, but with the rich at his death, because he had done no violence, nor was any deceit in his mouth. Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him. He has put him to grief. When you make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed, he shall prolong his days, and the pleasure of the Lord shall prosper in his hands.
Music but its own.
adored and magnified. Crown him the Lord of years, the potentate of time, creator of the rolling spheres, ineffably sublime. All hail, Redeemer, hail, for thou hast died for me. Thy praise and glory shall not fail throughout all of eternity.
Amen.
Jesus born to die, born to die upon a tree. Jesus born to die, born to die for you and me. Sin and guilt that bruised and wounded him. It was our sin that brought him down. When we like sheep had gone astray, our shepherd came, and on his shoulders bore our shame.
I could not believe my ears. Some of the same voices that cried, "Hosanna," now shouted, "Crucify him." I also could not believe my eyes. Arms and hands that had waved to greet him were now clenched, demanding his death. In just a few days, the world had turned upside down. I followed him along the winding road outside the city, his bleeding back straining under the weight of the cross. I stood on the hill of the skull and watched the steel spikes driven through his flesh as a crown of thorns pierced his brow. I listened to the voices, once filled with praise, now hurling insults and curses. How could people turn so quickly on the one they called their king? As I stood beneath the cross and watched the agony of death wrench his body, I heard him pray, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." Only the King of Heaven could have uttered such words of compassion. Those final moments. The city was Jerusalem. The time was long ago. The people called him Jesus. The crime was the love he showed, and I'm the one to blame. I caused all the pain. He gave himself the day he wore my crown. He brought me love that only he could give. I brought him cause to cry. And though he taught me how to live, I
you die. And I'm the one to blame. I caused all the pain. He gave himself the day he wore my crown. He could have called his holy father and said, take me away, please take me away. He could have said, I'm not guilty and I'm not gonna stay. But he walked right through the gate and then on up the hill. And as he fell beneath the weight, he cried, Father, not my will, and I'm the one to blame. I caused all the pain. He gave himself the day he wore my crown. He gave himself the day he wore my
Jesus answered and said to him, Are you the teacher of Israel, and do not know these things? Most assuredly I say to you, we speak what we know and testify what we have seen, and you do not receive our witness. If I have told you earthly things, and you do not believe, how will you believe if I tell you heavenly things? No one has ascended to heaven, but he who came down from heaven, that is, the Son of Man who is in heaven. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but the world through him might be saved.
By the blood of an innocent.
my Savior, waiting the coming day, Jesus my Lord. Up from the grave he arose, with a mighty triumph for his foes. He arose a victor from the dark domain, and he lives forever with his saints to reign. He arose, he arose, hallelujah, Christ arose. Gravely they watch his bed, Jesus my Savior. Vainly they seal the dead, Jesus my Lord. Up from the grave he arose, with a mighty triumph for his foes. He arose a victor from the dark domain, and he lives forever with his saints to reign. He arose, he arose, hallelujah, Christ arose. Death cannot keep his prey, Jesus my Savior. He tore the bars away, Jesus my Lord. Up from the grave he arose, with a mighty triumph for his foes. He arose a victor from the dark domain, and he lives forever with his saints to reign. He arose, he arose, hallelujah, Christ arose.
Now on the first day of the week, very early in the morning, they and certain other women with them came to the tomb bringing the spices which they had prepared. But they found the stone rolled away from the tomb. And then they went in and did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. And it happened, as they were greatly perplexed about this, that behold, two men stood by them in shining garments. Then, as they were afraid and bowed their faces to the earth, they said to them, "Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, but is risen. Remember how he spoke to you when he was still in Galilee, saying, 'The Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men, and be crucified, and the third day rise again?'"
Lord, the King of Kings, my redeeming Lord. I will live to sing your praise for now and evermore. Hallelujah to the risen Lamb. Hallelujah to the risen Lamb. Hallelujah to the King. Hallelujah to the Lord of Lords. To the risen Lamb we sing. To the risen Lamb we sing. To the risen Lamb we sing. And majesty, he is alive, he is alive. God loves us so, see here his hands, his feet, his side. Yes, we know he is alive.
Jesus healed not only my physical darkness, but my spiritual darkness as well. When he touched me, a glorious light filled my life, and the darkness of sin and even death had been conquered. The king I saw riding on a colt that day in Jerusalem is now the mighty King of Kings, my King of Kings, reigning in heaven forevermore.
Blessing and glory, wisdom and thanks, worship and honor, power and strength, be to our God forever and ever, be to the Lamb forever and evermore. Amen. Crown him with many crowns, the Lamb upon his throne. Hark how the heavenly anthem drowns all music but its own. Awake my soul and sing of him died for thee, and hail him as thy matchless king throughout eternity. Crown him the Lord of life, who triumphed o'er the grave, who rose victorious to the strife for those he came to save. His glories now we sing, who died and rose on high, who died eternal life to bring, and lives that death may die. Our God reigns, our God reigns, our God reigns, our God reigns, our God reigns.
is thankful that Jesus Christ reigns and rules. He is on the throne today. He died on the cross for our sins, and death couldn't keep him. Amen.
That is correct.
He is not just the one who died for our sins, but he conquered death, and he's on the throne today. Amen.
Amen.
And now it's time to hear from God's word. Brother Matt, if you would come up. Well, I had a pretty long sermon made out, but I'm going to try to abbreviate it because of things. Mm-hmm. This is the time of year that we especially look at the sacrifice that Jesus made for us. We look at what Jesus did for us, both his death and his resurrection, what it means to us. First part of his death that I do want to bring up is that he was always in control. You know, he knew what was going to happen. They didn't catch him off guard. The Roman soldiers didn't catch him, and he didn't know what to do, and they forced him on the cross. He didn't do that. He did it on purpose for us. You know what? He's in Matthew 26:1. He said, it says, now it came to pass, when Jesus had finished all these sayings, he said to his disciples, you know that after 2 days is the Passover, and the Son of Man will be delivered up to be crucified. He wasn't caught off guard, was he? And this is what happened when he was arrested. When Jesus had spoken these words, he went out with his disciples over the brook Kidron, where there was a garden, in which he and his disciples entered. And Judas, who betrayed him, also knew the place, for Jesus had often met there with his disciples. And Judas, having received a detachment of troops and officers, came from the chief priests and Pharisees, came there with lanterns, torches, and weapons. Jesus, therefore, knowing all things that would come upon him, went forward and said to them, whom are you seeking? They answered him, Jesus of Nazareth. Jesus said to them, I am. He is apostrophized because it wasn't actually in the original Greek. What he said was, I am, the name that God gave Moses. He's the great I am. Judas, which betrayed him, stood with them. Now when he said to them, I am, they drew back and fell to the ground, just simply saying those words. God of the universe saying, I am, was enough. Do you think that he couldn't have escaped if he wanted? But he let it happen because that was the whole purpose why he came here. There are people who actually teach the heresy that Jesus didn't need to die, but he did. He died for a very specific purpose. Isaiah 53:5 says, but he was wounded for our transgressions. If you could bring it up there. Okay. He was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement for our peace was upon him, and by his stripes we are healed. Hebrews chapter 9, starting with verse 22, it says, and according to the law, almost all things are purified with blood, and without the shedding of blood, there's what? No remission. Without the shedding of blood, can your sins be forgiven? And he had a reason. He went through all that for you and for me. Now, if you think about the torture of the cross. That was one of the worst punishments anyone could go through. Just being beaten with a cat of nine tails. Mm-hmm. That alone could kill a lot of people. Mm-hmm. He went through for you and for me.
as he loved us. God so loved the world. Mm-hmm. He gave his only begotten son. I'd just like to point out he went through all that for us because he loved us. Well, that's on the day he wore my crown, because on that day he was taking our punishment, what we deserve. I'm going to thankful that he didn't stay in that grave.
Amen.
And I'm going to skip far ahead to 1 Corinthians 15, starting with verse 12. Because we know that he did rise from the dead. And that has a lot of implications for us. Amen. Now, if Christ is preached that he has been raised from the dead, how do some among you say that there is no resurrection of the dead? There were people who were saying there is no resurrection of the dead. Now, there were early Christians who were saying that there's no rising from the dead, but they at the same time say they believe that Jesus rose from the dead. That there's nothing more after this life. But that isn't the case, is it? All of us have loved ones in heaven. We're going to see them again, amen? So if there's no resurrection of the dead, then Christ is not risen. And if Christ is not risen, then our preaching is empty and your faith is also empty. Yes, and we have found false witnesses of God, because if we have testified of God that he raised up Christ and he did not raise, if in fact the dead do not rise. But if the dead do not rise, then Christ is not risen. If Christ is not risen, your faith is futile. You're still lost in your sins. What's saying is that our faith is all dependent on the fact that Jesus Christ rose from the dead. That's what our foundation is. Also, those who fall asleep in Christ have perished. If in this life we only have hope in Christ, we are of all men the most pitiable. You know, if we didn't have that blessed hope, what would be the point of any? You know, he said we, because we're the one. One's going through the Christian life. If there is no point in it, if there's no resurrection of the dead, what is the point in any of it if we just die and we're gone? But now Christ is risen from the dead and has become the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since by man came death, by man also came the resurrection of the dead. That's an interesting thing about it. Goes all the way back to Adam. You know, those who don't believe in Genesis 1-11, I don't know how they reconcile that, because there was a real Adam who sinned, and there was a real Jesus Christ who paid the penalty for all our sin and rose from the dead, second Adam. As in Adam all die, so in Christ what? Amen. And he died for us, and he rose again, and made salvation so simple that if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that what? You will be saved. So simple. It's foundational. This is basics, but it's so important. Our faith is in the literal Jesus Christ, who came to earth some 2,000 years ago, died on the cross for our sins, and he rose from the dead, conquering death, conquering sin. But then something else happened. Acts 1:9, this is the last verses I'm going through, as we skipped most of my sermon. Now when this is the resurrected Jesus Christ, had spoken these things, while they watched, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. Could you imagine being there and seeing that? That would be so incredible to see. And while they looked steadfastly toward heaven as he went up, behold, two men stood by them in white apparel, the angels, who also said, Men of Galilee, why do you stand gazing up into heaven? I want everyone to read this sentence. This same Jesus, I'll read, this same Jesus, who was taken up from you into heaven, will so come in like manner as you saw him go into heaven. See, our hope doesn't end here. Jesus is coming back, and how many are looking forward to that day?
Amen.
And that is why we celebrate Easter. We celebrate that Jesus came, died for our sins, rose from the grave, and he is coming back. Amen?
Amen.
Lord Jesus, we thank you so much for what we're celebrating here. We thank you so much. Without you dying for our sins, we'd still be in our sins, because there is no forgiveness without your blood. Lord, we thank you that you rose from the grave, giving us hope. And we thank you so much that you are coming back again. And we so look forward to that day. Be with us and the rest of the day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hello, I'm Pastor Larry Evans, and you've been watching a New Life Church video. If it has been a blessing, please like, share, subscribe, and comment on it. We'd love to hear from you. Our website is www.newlifenwin.org and has our schedule as well as more information about us. God bless.